I gotta say, first of all, congrats on you guys on going public.
Thank you.
Wow. That's a weird thing. No ring.
One day.
How did that start? When did you guys first find out you guys even like
this is a product of workplace sexual harassment.
What?
Exactly.
Who was harassing Jeremy.
Esther was harassing Jeremy.
Who would you even report that to, though?
He had HR. He quit.
Yeah, he quit on us. He said, this is too much stress for me to handle.
Let me take one step back, though, with you, because I saw a little bit of how it all happened.
Yeah.
You know, but when you first felt that about Jeremy, like, what was it? Was it like the entrepreneurial spirit?
No, I didn't care about that.
You didn't give a fuck about that?
No, when I first met him, I was like, this guy's a nerd. This guy's a geek.
Yeah, but girls love nerds, right?
I could tell you're like the good guy or the good boy out of the group. Oh, he's a nice guy.
No, I would agree. We don't even have to argue that.
Don't even try to pretend. Like, yeah. I'm not pretending. I'm
Esther
so
does look like she's dated some K-Town goons in her life.
No, actually, no.
Not at all, really?
I mean, come on.
No, not really. No.
I feel like you've dated a couple Caspers and Spookies and Creepies and Sleepies. You know, the Seven Dwarves. Yeah.
Seven Dwarves.
No,
Not really. Okay. Not really. Actually, most of them aren't even from LA. So
where are they? OC?
Like Orange County area.
Oh. There's goons in OC.
No, 100%.
There's a lot of goons.
No, I have, but not that many. Not that many.
Oh, you're like a Fullerton, Buena Park type of, right? Is that what we're talking
about? Maybe a little bit.
Garden Grove?
Yeah, so you saw Jeremy, and what was it about Jeremy? Okay,
in the beginning, there was nothing. And then later on, we were on
literally nothing.
Honestly, no, I was just like, these are the people I work with. I didn't even consider him a friend when I first came on.
Which I thought was weird.
Because they all thought we were friends.
If you work with someone, you would think that we're friends.
No, I get it. Because when she came on, she was just a guest at first.
I'd be like, oh, like I know them.
Right.
But I'm not like, oh, like we're close, you know?
Do you think he was cute? Did you think he was cute?
In the beginning?
Yeah, like at all. Like, were you like physically attracted to
him? What was your hair like back then?
I don't remember.
If you look back, it looks like a helmet.
You guys all got great hair, I will say that.
Oh, thank you.
Imagine his hair without the mullet. That's what my hair looked like.
That's true. It did. But yeah,
I started this wave.
It's true.
I could see that.
I like the sides are parting. You know, at one point, all the kids on TikTok were wearing, like, you guys had it in the front, like the lanyon at the front. Now everyone's like slowly opening up their foreheads a bit. Yeah. It's like a new.
Yeah, that's what I used to have, just like right here.
Right.
That's true.
I'll roll this off though. Long hair sucks.
How do you feel about that?
She has no say. I really don't. Yeah.
Wait, who wears the pants in the relationship?
Esther.
We both. No. We both do.
Outside looking in, we're voting Esther.
You know what was funny in that new episode of the pod was when you were talking about when you actually mentioned, like, you guys thought she was hot too.
And then you guys pointed out
like how weird that was, and I was like, yeah, that was a little weird actually.
That was weird.
Why is that weird to be like you could appreciate somebody's physical beauty?
It is funny because there's times where I end up dating a girl that all the homies was like pursuing at one point, and we just have to ignore the fact.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Ignore it. I don't want to remember
forward,
it.
We just ignore it. Like it never happened. Like it wasn't like we. None of us tried to
and
smash.
Then he went on to tell me about her head game right after that.
No.
God.
No, hold up. Whoa.
Oh my God.
Whoa. That is crazy. What was the question? What was the question you guys asked?
The question was, what was your honeymoon like?
No,
and then you immediately started going.
They asked her. They were like, "How rate Jeremy's
sexual
stroke game?
Stroke game. Rate Jeremy's." And then they said, "Esther, rate." Wait. Then they asked Jeremy,
like
"Rate
reverse,
Esther's stroke game?" And the thing that I mentioned was just like, this is also just a public question. I'd actually like to ask you.
Yeah.
Have you ever had mind-blowing head?
Mind-blowing?
That made you think about it for weeks after. Or when was the first time you've had, like, it's like you remember it to this day.
I will say this. I do feel like my most mind-blowing sexual experiences are like, you know, the early days. You remember like those days where you just get high and you're having like high sex and the shit's amazing? Like shit just hasn't been like that ever anymore. You know what I mean? Like I've done way too many drugs at this point. Like everything is pretty much on the same plane. Like there's good shit, you know, there's like mid, But like back in the day, like it was just amazing. You could be in a shithole apartment with roaches and a tiny studio apartment, but the sex was fire in the summertime, you know, like you just sweat and drenched. Now you could have all the amenities, you know, jacuzzi, nice house, comfortability, and it could still be wet.
I feel like he's like Bear Grylls. He needs to have like obstacles that he has to get through to enjoy his night.
He's in a survival situation.
I walk 3 miles in the snow for some head. You know when you hear your parents say that shit? Like, I walked 3 miles in the snow for school. I'm like, no, you didn't. Didn't even snow where you're from.
But I was basically talking to some of my friends, and they were like, all of them repeatedly were like, they could count on one hand the times that they've had mind-blowing head. Mm-hmm. And he's never had it.
He's never had it.
Maybe you're just not into it, though. Would you say that that's not one
head?
Of your
favorite? That's what people say if they've never had mind blowing.
He's like, I assure you, I am quite into head. Yeah.
She doesn't talk to me and I receive pleasure. What is there not to like?
But I think people say that when they haven't had mind blowing, you know?
Oh, wow. There's a level. What were you saying about this? Or were you going to...
No, I was just saying that they asked the question. They prompted it. So,
but there was like, no question about head, by the way.
It was about sex.
Sophie's just like, where are you going with this?
I could see. Yeah, exactly. Let me ask you this. Is there in a job like this, it's podcasting, does the same rules maybe not apply with dating a coworker? Since, you know, it's not like you're working at Farmers Insurance. I don't know why I said that job. That's a place I worked at. I shouldn't have said that. But yeah.
Well, no, because I think it's the same. But at first, when she joined the podcast, I was like, okay, purely platonic, purely professional. And then when she started hitting on me, I was like...
Aggressively.
Yeah.
That's what we meant by harassment, workplace harassment.
At first, I kind of ignored it, but then she hit me up on the privately and was like, no, I actually want to take you out to dinner. And so in my brain, I was like, okay, you're attractive and we'll see, right? So then when we started talking and I was like, oh, I actually like her. Like, she's easy to get along to. She's funny. There's a lot that we connect on. So I was like, okay, if we date, let's keep it private, because if it doesn't work out, then we can just go back to... you don't have to let the public know. It doesn't ruin the coworkers or anything like that. You know?
I was like, another man that wants to keep me in the closet. Another private.
Why? You've had that experience with other boyfriends? Yes. Why would they want to keep you in the closet?
I guess, okay, the first ex, I was the mistress. So I was kept secret. And then the second one was
kept
because...
in the closet?
Not like, you know what I mean. Not like,
she's a bit of a fob.
Keep you hidden.
That's what I meant. You guys know. And then the second one was that I think he wanted to have like options open. Like, he liked me, but he liked the fact that other girls were
just on some fuckboy shit.
Yes. Yeah.
Do you have an exit strategy though? If things don't, I mean, I hope it works out, but if it doesn't, do you guys like write something out that's like, okay, we know how this can.
Yeah, we sell the podcast.
Yeah, no. Hey, you no longer see Esther on the podcast. That's the exit plan.
We're going to have to hold tryouts or something.
We've seen some couples on podcasts go wrong, like Bobby and Kalila is a famous podcast duo.
I followed all the internet drama.
That was a huge drama.
And I've also followed the people that have done like in-depth videos. Of course, you probably know the actual details, but like people that are studying.
Did you keep that in mind, thinking about that relationship? I mean,
I think what Bobby does is way harder. And something he said in one of his episodes was, that he regrets being so open about the relationship publicly. So something we talk about is being private but not secret. So like I will draw a line about certain things we will or won't talk about.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I don't want a situation to happen. We're arguing about it online. The audience have partial story and then all of a sudden I have to explain myself more or whatever it is. They're taking her side blindly. Now I have to fight the comments.
I think you guys will be fine. You guys handled this very well.
Yeah.
Jeremy lets the comments ruin his opinion.
No, I don't. The minute I see a negative comment on a video, I don't look at the rest of them. Yeah. I just don't.